Hey guys, what's up? So I'm gonna be doing another unboxing. This time it's this. I'm gonna open this again. I mean, not again, but I'm gonna open another box. Got me a Blu-ray writer. I think it's LG. Here's just the smaller box inside the box. So we got the box. Oh man, it's the battery thing low again. There it is. See what you got? We got the LG. Now we're gonna figure out to put this in the thing. We need one of the things to plug in the back. The SATA. I think it's about the SATA power and the SATA aid for the data. So we're just gonna have to figure it out. Once we hook it up. I gotta put the power here and then the data here once I put it on the front. So this is the Blu-ray writer. It can read and write Blu-ray. Now just in case, you know, just in case the Blu-ray, or not the Blu-ray, the hard drive fails, I can back up the data on this. Also got this. This is Blu-ray, blank Blu-rays. They hold about 25 gigs each. It's the Verbatim. There you go. God, I'm trying to figure this out. Turn that off. Gotta open this. What I need to do is put it right here. Basically, I gotta remove this panel right here. That's where it's gonna go in. I need some air duster so I can clean the dust. Okay. Fell down here. Yep. It did. Great. Gotta remove this front panel. There's the front panel. First. solid reach. Oh wait, I'm gonna have to switch the... Okay. And this one. Wait a sec.
Open this.
So these are the cables I'm gonna use for the Blu-ray drive. I think I'll use this one, the Molex to SATA to Molex to SATA. If I need to extend this, I'll add the thing. Okay, let's check it out. Wait. This is the extension for the SATA power. Here, if I need a longer one. I can get some screws. Oh, I forgot. Gotta get the screwdriver. I gotta find which one fits over here. These two and this side. I think that one too. I'll figure it out. I need this. Oh yeah, I gotta put the cables in first. Go on this side. Now I gotta find the cable. I'll use this one. And then this one, I'm gonna connect this right here. This. Put that here. Then I'll put the SATA here. This one. Let's see if I can find another one. There we go. And the other side goes here. Nice. Gotta close this back forgot. I forgot. I guess this has to stay out. Oh well. Okay, I see. That's why. Guess I didn't need this after all.
power. Okay, let's test it. Old because, well, it's a DVD. It's not Blu-ray, but I'll try it anyway. I know this thing can play Blu-rays, but we'll check it out. Probably gonna play. Okay. Just click on that. Play DVD. Let's try this one. Doing something. Oh, there we go. It works. Scene selection. Nice DVD. We'll try a Blu-ray. I don't have a Blu-ray though, do I? Yeah. I have these bombs. Hey, where did I put that? Maybe later. Not bad for a DVD. I mean, it's not as good as Blu-ray quality, but you expect it's DVD. Advent children. There you go. Alright, let's stop it. Okay. Hey, do I gotta eject it? This is it. Let's see. Do I gotta eject this? Right eject, right click, and then eject. It should eject. There we go. Hey, DVD works fine. A little bit scratched up, but still works. I'll try these. Basically like blank DVDs. I used to write blank DVDs back then. Stored a lot of stuff on blank DVDs. Still got those too. But, you know, that was when I was writing stuff on blank DVDs instead of Blu-ray discs. Way, way, way back. Back like in the early 2000s. So these, we'll use one of these. This is a blank Blu-ray disc. It's about 25 gigs per disc. It's pretty big. Is that a it's pretty thick. Or am I holding too long? Oh wait, no, it's the plastic cover. See if it's gonna read it. Just curious. It's doing something. Okay, there we go. BDRE Blu-ray drive rewritable or recordable. Select to choose what happens with blank Blu-ray discs. Okay. So we can burn stuff into this disc. Burn files to disk, file explorer. Yeah, so basically it's kind of like similar to how I was doing DVDs. You can do a DVD or a USB flash drive. Save it and delete files on disk and have the disk will blah blah blah. With the CD DVD player, burn files in groups, individual files can be edited or removed after burning. The disk will also work on most computers. So yeah. Cancel, we'll go ahead and eject it. I'm gonna write stuff on this disc later. Eject. Nice. Okay, that's it. Works fine. There you go. That's how you install a Blu-ray drive. I decided I want to move the Blu-ray up here. Okay. I don't know, because the wires are in the way, so maybe that'll help. I think that's all I gotta remove. Okay. Remove this. First, I gotta open the other side. Okay. Okay. I'm gonna have to remove this real quick. Oh wait, maybe I can just pull it. I'll just do that. I'll go ahead and remove it. And the top one. Okay, I got an idea. I think I'm just gonna move this down like this. There we go. That'll work. Nice. Easier. It's easier that way. Okay, I guess put the thing on the top. Oh, wait. How to put this back here. Oh, wait, what am I doing? I gotta put the screws on first. First, I gotta put the Blu-ray on the top. There we go. Nice. That's better. Then I gotta screw the thing. One. And that's two. Then we'll do the Blu-ray. Now we can put this. Oh, wait. You forget. Top one. Gonna see if it works. Before I close it, just in case. What the? Whoa. Ah, wait, I gotta shut it off again. Messed up. Put that power first. Okay, let's try again. Alright, it's better on the top anyway. Alright, so let's go ahead and close it. It's done. I put this, so I switched them places, you know, put this on the top, put this on the bottom. There we go, nice. There we go, I'm done.